This is a quick tutorial on how to define slab support conditions in SeismoBuild and SeismoStruct's building modeler. Let's select slab S3. And let's take a look at the support conditions of the slab. The support conditions indicate toward which beams the slab loads are distributed. We can see that the slab is supported on all its edges by the beam adjacent to the slab from the sketch, with all edges characterized by a bold green line and from the description for each edge. We can change the support conditions by clicking on an edge. And, we can see the green solid line becoming broken, and the description reading free, instead of supported. Let's do the same, for the opposite edge of the slab, the edge adjacent to beam B1. And now, let's make the two edges supported again. Now we will modify the angle between the local axes of the slab reinforcement and the global axes of the plan view of the floor. The local axes indicate the directions along which the slab reinforcement is distributed. We can rotate the local axes by modifying the value of the angle.